of implicit functions. Differentiation of implicit functions, or functions which are defined implicitly. So first of all, what is the meaning of an implicit function? So implicit function is basically where your variables x and y cannot be separated out easily. See, up till now what happened, most of the functions that you got were of the type y is equal to f of x, where there was a clear cut, or you could, you know, easily separate the two variables from each other. So the independent variable x and the dependent variable y, terms could be separated out from each other. So finding dy by dx was easy. So this is called explicitly defined function. This is called explicitly defined function. Explicitly defined function. Okay. So today we are going to talk about implicitly defined function, where your x and y separation is very, very difficult. So I cannot write y as a function of x. So it's basically a mixed function of x and y. Okay. Equal to zero or equal to constant, whatever you want to say. Okay. So this is a implicitly defined function. Implicitly defined function. Implicitly defined function. To give you some examples for the same, let's say I have a function like this. I have a function like this. Sine square y plus cos of xy equal to 1. So this is an example of an implicitly defined function. So how do we find dy by dx in this case? That is what we are going to learn. How to find dy by dx in this case? That's what we are going to learn in this particular expression. So what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to, let's say, call this term. Let's say I have this function and I want to find dy by dx. Okay. So I will call this term as, let's say, u. Okay. Let's say I call this term as a u. Okay. Now, let's say I differentiate both sides with respect to x. I differentiate both sides with respect to x. Okay. Now see how this works. How this works. If you differentiate this with respect to t, let's not write x as of now. Let me just give you a very generic idea. If you differentiate this with respect to t, du by dt will be, please make a note of this. This is something which is beyond your school level syllabus. It is dou f by dou x into dx by dt plus dou f by dou y into dy by dt. Basically, what you have used here is actually a complete form of a chain rule. This is called total differential. So if you're differentiating u with respect to t, and since this function has x and y as its input, you can write this as dou f. So let's say u is equal to f x comma y. You are differentiating with respect to t. So this is how this expression will come out. You will study more about this in your undergraduate syllabus, early in your second or third semester of engineering college. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to equate this to zero. And what I'm going to do is, because it is a constant, I'm equating it to zero, because constant derivative with respect to anything will be zero, right? So derivative of this with respect to t, anything would be zero, right? Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to change my t with an x. Earlier I didn't want to use x because then you would not get a feel of this term. It would become a one actually. Now I want you to realize that this term is also there. So what I'll do, I'll put my t as an x. Okay. So this expression here would become dou f by dou x into dx by dx. This will become dou f by dou y into dy by dx. Got it? Okay. So what has happened in this case? This will become a 1. So your dy by dx can be written as minus dou f by dou x divided by dou f by dou y. Okay. So everybody, please make a note of this. This is the expression for dy by dx for a function which has been implicitly defined. This is an expression for dy by dx for a function which has been implicitly defined. Okay. Now, normally what happens for school exams, we don't use this formula. Okay, so I'll write it down. Use it only for competitive exams. Use it for competitive exams. Okay, so how does this work? Let us take this example itself, which I had quoted over here. So let's say this is your implicitly defined function, and I want to find dy by dx. Okay. Now, in school, what do they say? They say that, okay, differentiate this from left to right and make dy by dx the subject of the formula. Correct? So if you do that, it becomes sine square y plus cos xy equal to 1. So let's differentiate both sides with respect to x. Okay. So if you differentiate this, it becomes 2 sine y cos y dy by dx. What will happen to this term? This term will become minus sine xy into derivative of xy. Derivative of xy will be
plus x dx.
Correct? Am I right? And this will be equal to 0. So this is your C, that, you know, the term which you wrote as a C on the, yeah, this part, C. Okay. Now, let us collect the terms having dy by dx in them. So you'll see terms here, which is 2 sine y cos y. Correct? From here, you will get minus x sine xy. Okay. And this term, if you take on the other side, it becomes y sine xy. Y sine xy. Okay. So dy by dx will become y sine xy upon 2 sine y cos y minus x sine xy. So this is when you don't use the formula. Okay. So the process is you differentiate from left to right, take dy by dx terms common, non-dy by dx containing terms, send it to the other side, and make dy by dx the subject of the formula. Okay, so this is how you would be doing it in the school exam. Okay, for competitive exams, what do we do is, I'll do it in the second way, this is your first way, second way. If you use the formula that we had discussed right now, dy by dx is minus dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y. See how the process will become super easy. You can do it in one step. Somebody has a question. Oh, sure. Okay. Yeah. What is the meaning of dou f by dou x? Dou f by dou x means you are differentiating by keeping only x as the variable. Y and constants will be treated as constants. So let me ask you this question. If you differentiate this with respect to, partially with respect to x, keeping y as a constant, what will happen? This term will go for 0. What will happen to this term? This term will become minus sine
y sine xy
into derivative of xy. Now remember, your y is a constant, so y will come out over here. Correct? Whole divided by dou f by dou y. Dou f by dou y means you have to keep x and constant as constants, only y will be treated as a variable. So this will become 2 sine y cos y. This will become minus sine xy into x. That's it. Done. Is this the answer that we had got? See, one step. One step is what is required. Of course, minus and minus will become a plus. This is what you will do for your J.
So 1 minute.
Yeah, sure. But please do not use the second formula for school exams. You straight away get no credit for it. Who knows, your parents and all may be called the other day for beating and all, what she is doing in the car, what he or she is doing in the school exams. See, second formula, you just have to follow this formula. Dhyan. If you're asking what is dou f by dou x, then let me tell you, dou f by dou x is the derivative of f with respect to x, keeping y as a constant. Of course, constants will be constant, but y will also be treated as a constant. So if you differentiate this, keeping y as a constant, sine y square or sine square y will be zero because it's a constant. Cos xy derivative will be minus sine xy into, now derivative of xy keeping y as a constant will just give you a y. It's like something like 2x. So 2 will come out, right? So same way y will come out. Got the point? No, they'll not be giving you more than two variables, but this is extendable. This formula is extendable, Venkat. So if that more than two variables, this formula is extendable. As you can see, du by dt will become dou f by dou x, dx by dt, dou f by dou y by dt, dy by dt, plus dou f by dou z into dz by dt.
Yes, sir.
Whatever you want to find out, you can find out from there.
Oh, okay.
Okay, this is something which is not there in your school syllabus, or for JE also they don't use it, but I'm just telling you in case, you know, it may be helpful to you.
Yeah, sir. So could you please scroll right, sir?
Yeah, why not?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir. 1 second.
Sure.
Yes, sir. Done, sir. Thank you, sir.
Done?
Yes, sir.
Let's take a question on this. Yeah, see, the meaning of dou f by dou x means, see, when there is a multivariate function, how does your function get affected, or what is the change in the function when there is a slight change in the value of x? That is called dou f by dou x. So what is the change in the function when there is a slight change in the value of y? That will be called dou f by dou y. So dou f by dou x basically says, when there is a multivariate function, if you fiddle with one variable, how does the function change? Right? That is called dou f by dou x. Okay. What is the meaning of derivative? Meaning of derivative is the change in the output when there is a small nudge in the input. Budge by nudge, right? Yeah. So, yeah. That is what is dou f by dou x. Similarly, dou f by dou y has a similar meaning, etc. Done?
So 1 minute, sir.
This is easy. Okay. Done, done, done. Very good. Just to remind you, people who joined late, we'll stop the class at 7:15 today in the light of your UTs going on. Okay, done. Again, thank you. So if you see this, you can write this as log x squared plus y squared minus 2 tan inverse y by x equal to 0. So you can treat this as your fx comma y, okay, equal to a constant. Constant is 0 over here. So dy by dx, I'll be using my shortcut formula, is minus dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y. Okay. So dou f by dou x will be what? It will be a negative of 2x by x square plus y square. Okay. Remember, you're treating y as a constant here. So this will become minus 2 by 1 plus y square by x square into minus y by x square into minus y by x square. Okay. Remember, y by x derivative, when you're doing, you'll treat only x as a variable, y is a constant. Whole divided by. Again, derivative with respect to y and treating x as a constant will be this minus into 1 by x, correct? Okay. Is this fine? So few things that we can do directly over here. We can make it as 2 plus 2y. So make it as plus 2y. Two factor you can remove from everywhere. Okay. And if you take x square up, if you take x square as a LCM over here, this x square gets cancelled with this x square. So you'll end up getting y upon this. Okay. Here also we can do the same. If you take x square as the LCM over here, okay, and take this x square on the top, that will get cancelled with this x, leaving you with the x on the top. Okay. So the numerator term is minus x plus y. Denominator term is minus y minus x. Remember, the denominators of both numerator and denominator will stand cancelled. So this is nothing but x plus y by x minus y, which is your RHS, hence root. Is that fine? Any question here?
No, sir.
Okay. Moving on. This is basically a twin set of problem which I am giving you. We'll solve only one of them. Normally in school exams also it appears. The question goes like this. If under root of 1 minus x square plus under root of 1 minus y square is ax minus y, then prove that dy by dx is given by under root of 1 minus y square by under root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Now, there are various versions of the same problem. The next version that you will probably see is this one. The next version that you'll see is this one. If under root of 1 minus x to the power 6
plus under root of 1 minus y to the power 6 is ax cube minus y cube. Then prove that dy by dx is going to be x square under root 1 minus y to the power 6 by y square under root 1 minus x to the power 6. Okay. If you look at a generic case, that's what we are going to do now. But I'm just apprising you of the different forms of the same problem that you may get. So if you see, the generic case is 1 minus x to the power 2n plus under root of 1 minus y to the power 2n. If it is this, then prove that dy by dx becomes x to the power n minus 1 under root of 1 minus y to the power 2n upon y to the power n minus 1 under root of 1 minus x to the power 2n. Let's do the last one. Let's do this one.
So what exactly is that A doing here, sir?
A is just a constant.
Okay. But can we do without it also?
Yeah. Nothing will happen. So A is just a constant. Very good, Trissy. Maths UT is over for you.
Monday, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, this problem, if you try to do with brute force, probably if you try to use your formula also, minus dou f by dou x upon dou f by dou y, you may not get the result very quickly. Okay. You may have to slog, you may have to struggle, you may have to spend a considerable amount of time to get the output. So what do we suggest over here is using some trick substitutions. Using some trick substitutions. Okay, so what I'll do is, I will take x to the power n as, let's say, sine of theta. And I'll take y to the power n as, let's say, sine of phi. Okay, so what I'm doing is, I'm going to take x to the power n as sine of theta and y to the power n as sine of phi. It is just for our simplification purpose. It has no role to play in the differentiation. It is just to simplify that given implicit function. Okay, so basically what I'm doing, I'm converting an implicit function into another implicit function. Okay. So now, this term over here will actually become under root of 1 minus sine square theta. This term over here will become under root of 1 minus sine square phi. Okay. And this is nothing but sine theta minus sine phi. So this is nothing but cos theta, this is nothing but cos phi, this is nothing but a sine theta minus sine phi. Okay, let us use our transformation formula that we had studied in our class 11th, cos a plus cos b formula. That's 2 cos a plus b by 2 into cos a minus b by 2. And this becomes 2a cos a plus b by 2 into sine a minus b by 2. Okay, 2 gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled, cos term gets cancelled, cos term gets cancelled. That will give you cot theta minus 5 by 2 as a. Okay, that means theta minus 5 by 2 is cot inverse a. Take a 2 on the other side. Okay, so this is where we reach out, reach up to. Now, what is theta? As per the given expression, theta is sine inverse of x to the power n. And phi is sine inverse y to the power n. And this is just a constant. You can call it as a c. Okay. Now, from here, we can use our implicit differentiation formula. Dy by dx is negative dou f by dou x upon dou f by dou y. Okay, so what will it become? So negative dou f by dou x will become what? 1 by under root of 1 minus square of this term. But at the same time, we have to use our chain rule. So x to the power n derivative is nx to the power n minus 1. Now remember, the other term is a term in y. So that will simply become a 0. You don't have to worry about it. Okay? Whole divided by dou f by dou y. Dou f by dou y, this will become a 0. This will become negative 1 by under root of, oh, I'm so sorry, I think I missed out a 2. 1 minus y to the power 2n into derivative of y with respect to y. Is this fine? Okay. Now, let's simplify these terms. So minus here and a minus here will be taken care. N and n will take care of themselves. So you'll end up getting x to the power n minus 1 under root of 1 minus y to the power 2n divided by y to the power n minus 1 under root of 1 minus x to the power 2n. Is that fine? Is this what you wanted to prove? Is this our right hand side?
Just yes, check. Sir.
Yeah. Okay, now people were saying done. How did you do it? Was there any other method or did you find longer time to do it? People who said done. Trigonometry. Okay. Okay. So this is a very classic problem. Normally it comes in school exams also, but in school exams, you'll probably get a lighter version. I think the first one probably you'll get max to max, the second one you'll get, but I took a generic case. This is a more generic case, general case. Okay. Let's take another one. Yeah. Let me put the poll on for this. Oh, sorry, Advaita. Do you want me to go back to the previous page, Advaita?
No, sir. I got it. Thank you.
Sorry, I missed your message. Five, four, three, two, one.
Please vote, everybody. Okay. Most of you have gone with option B. Let's check. See, guys, you don't have to start differentiating the function from the word go. You can make some small changes into the function. For example, let me write it like this. Okay. Let me square both the sides. So this will give you x square 1 plus y is equal to y square 1 plus x. Okay. So this will give you x square y minus xy square plus x square minus y square equal to 0. Okay. Take xy common over here. And take x plus y, x minus y common over here. So that'll give you two expressions over here. One is this and the other is that. Okay. Now probably x equal to y. Yeah, probably x equal to y is an extraneous factor that has crept into the system. Okay. So this is an extraneous factor because x need not be equal to y. Right? That means the factor which we are interested here is the other one. So this is the one where we are interested in. Okay. This is the one which is important to us. This probably has come because of the process of squaring. As Venkat is rightly pointing out, squaring may change the function, may introduce extra roots into the system. That's why this factor has come into the system. Okay. And anyways, if your y is equal to x, then dy by dx is going to be 1, which is not in your options. Okay, so let's not worry about the other factor. So let's worry about this guy, xy plus x plus y equal to 0. Now this is, this is actually an explicit function. You can express x in terms of y or y in terms of x. But let me tell you the formula which I have discussed with you is equally applicable for cases where you take a bit of effort to separate x and y. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll treat this as fx, y. Okay, and directly apply my formula dou f by dou x is minus dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y. Okay, so the derivative of this with respect to x, keeping y as a constant, will just give you y, and this will give you a 1. Correct? Okay, what about the denominator terms? Denominator term will give you a 1 plus x. Okay. Now hold on. This doesn't match with your options, but that doesn't mean you have done it wrongly. That doesn't mean you have done it incorrectly. Probably they want you to replace your y completely in terms of x. They want you to replace your y completely in terms of x, which anyways we can do it from here. So we can say y 1 plus x is negative x. So y is negative x by 1 plus x. Okay, so place it over here. So it becomes negative 1 plus y, 1 plus y upon 1 plus x. So if you simplify this, that clearly leads to the result minus 1. Minus 1 upon 1 plus x the whole square, which is option number B. Now, I'm not saying this is the only way to do the problem. You could have done it by other ways or as well. Okay. But just be aware that you don't have to start differentiating in the raw form as given to you in the question. Is that fine? Any questions here? Any concerns?
So could you go to the left?
Yeah, why not?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. That question gone.
Yes,
sir.
Sir, in this case, it was quite easy to determine which was the extraneous roots. But then, yeah. In other cases, how exactly do we do it?
You have to get it clarified from the options. You have to see which option. Yeah, which option is basically meeting your requirements. Okay.
Yes, sir. So could you give an example like that?
There's no ready-made example as of now in my mind, but I'll do one thing. I'll just send you a few questions based on that.
Okay, sir.
I'm unable to find my question, so I'll give you my question. Let's say, yeah, this is basically an equation of a family of conic passing through origin. Okay. This is basically an example of a family of conic passing through origin. It also includes a pair of straight lines, by the way. Okay. Then dy by dx is which of the following? Option A. Why did I put a bracket unnecessarily? Yeah. Option A is minus x by y. Option B, minus y by x. Option C, y by x. Option D, x by y. I'll put the poll on. All right, at the count of five, I'll stop. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so 25 of you have voted so far, and 60% of those people say option C. Okay. Now, very easy question to, prima facie, it looks easy, but most of the effort probably may go into the simplification because you can see in the answer there is no A, there is no B, there is no H. So to begin with, we'll use the formula dy by dx is minus dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y, where this is your f. This is your f. Okay. So minus dou f by dou x, minus dou f by dou x means you're differentiating only with respect to x as a variable. So that will be 2ax. This will be 2hy. Dou f by dou y will give you 2hx plus 2by. Okay. The factor of 2 can be removed. So it becomes negative ax plus hy by hx plus by. Now, what to do from here on, because my answer is in a different format. So what I'm going to do is, we all know that
y square common.
No, we can break this term like this. Let me just put a thing. So what you can do is we can break this 2hxy as hxy and hxy. So I'll do ax square plus hxy
And the other term, I'll take it on the other side. So minus b y square h x y. Okay. So if you take x common from here, you get ax plus hy. And if you take a y common from here, you get hx plus by. By the way, this is b, probably may look like an h. Yeah. Okay. So from here, we can directly say ax plus hy by hx plus by. Of course, you can borrow a negative sign. That will become y upon x. That will become y upon x. So this answer that you have got over here is actually y upon x. That's nothing but option number C. Most of you got this correct. 60% of you voted for C. Very good. Any questions here?
No.
Any questions here? Somebody was asking something.
Yes, sir. We also learned, let's assume for time being, I know I'm complicating it, but just for knowledge sake or whatever, like let's assume for some time that these are pair of straight lines.
Okay.
Sir, and let's assume they're parabola also, like separate case. So
slope is y by x. Okay, that's most of you would have solved it by that method also. That's a very excellent method of solving it. Excellent. Okay. Okay, so Tripan also has some question. Tripan, you're saying something? Tripan? Oh, no, Tripan is also
same thing.
Tripan is also saying the same thing, yes. Okay.
So, at the origin, then there'll be two slopes. No, sir.
Yeah, so I'm not saying it is differentiable at the origin. As you can see, it will become 0 by 0 form.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, it is non-differentiable at the origin.
Yes, sir.
Next question. You have to take log. Yeah, try this one. Poll is on. I think this is very straightforward. You just have to use your formula and your result should be there. But if you go by the school method of finding dy by dx for the entire expression, differentiating it from left to right, well, you'll have to waste some time collecting your dy by dx terms. Okay, in another 45 seconds, we'll stop.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Please vote, only 12 of you have voted. 3 minutes is good enough a time for this kind of problem. 3 minutes. Okay. End of poll. Maximum people have voted for option A. A is the most voted for option. Okay. Let's check. See again. If I were you, I will just use my formula dy by dx is negative dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y. Okay. Guys, be careful about this negative sign. I've seen people missing out on this negative sign. As a result, they get a negative of the actual answer. Okay. So negative dou f by dou x. Now dou f by dou x, you have to treat x only as a variable. Everything else should be treated with a constant. Okay. So this will just be 2x e to the power y. Okay. Just 2x e to the power y. This will be 2y is like a constant. So you can take out. So you have e to the power x plus x e to the power x. Correct. Whole divided by dou f by dou y. Dou f by dou y, the first term will just give you x square e to the power y. Okay. Second term will give you 2x e to the power x. Okay. Just do one small thing. Divide throughout with e to the power x because this doesn't match with any one of the answers. So just divide by e to the power x, both numerator and denominator. So this will give you negative 2x e to the power y minus x minus 2y x plus 1 upon, this will become x square e to the power y minus x, and this will become 2x. Is there any option which says so? Ah, yeah, there you go. Option number A. So A is absolutely correct. Got it? Much convenient method if you are using this formula, but equally cumbersome, or you can say you have to collect all your terms with dy by dx, collect all your terms without dy by dx, and then make dy by dx a subject of the formula. But unfortunately, you have to follow the same in school. You can't do anything about that.
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Sir, in school, just asking, could we use the proof you gave? Like, let's say they gave a question and we prove the formula you gave. And then we use it.
Yes, sir. They say if you want to use anything else extra, you can prove it, then use it.
Yeah.
They say, yeah, but I've seen them that they deduct marks for that. I don't know why they do that, but they don't keep their promise. Now, seriously, I mean, some of my students tried proving it, L'Hopital rule, and they started, you know, solving it, but they were not honored. They were not given marks. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So let's not try it. If at all there's a problem, let's not do it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's take. Easy. Most of you are able to do it quickly. Khatam. So this is basically y is equal to under root of sine x plus y. So y square is equal to sine x plus y. Now I would basically do this problem by the use of my implicit differentiation. I write it like this. Okay. So dy by dx is negative of dou f by dou x. So derivative of this is going to be with respect to x is going to be just negative cos x by dou f by dou y. So this will give you 2y. This will give you a 0. This will give you a minus 1. So as you can see, you can get the answer in straight away 2 or 3 steps. Good enough?
Sir, could you show the previous slide for 1 second?
Previous slide for 1 second?
Yes, sir. Okay. I got disconnected.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So that doesn't mean squaring always gives extraneous roots, Venkat. It may give extraneous roots. Got it? Okay.